believe in spanking. One woman took it to a whole other extreme, fatal level. Hi everyone, I'm Sandra Matos. Welcome to IO2. Get ready to be overloaded. In New York, a little boy was beaten to death because he couldn't spell. 3-year-old Ethan Ali was beaten to death by his aunt, 21-year-old Kristen Dale. Ethan's body was found in a Brooklyn apartment covered with belt buckle marks. Dale actually admitted repeatedly hitting him because he was struggling with his spelling lessons. An autopsy showed that Ethan had suffered extensive bruising to his torso, his legs, his buttocks, his arms, everywhere, including his skull. In court, the lawyer defending Dale says that she is heartbroken after what's happened. He said, "What we have here is a tragic result of what can only be described as excessive discipline gone wrong." Actually, that's not the only way it could be described. How about she was just simply crazy? On the day of his death, Ethan has stayed home sick. Dale looked after Ethan as a favor to his mom and sister, Natasha. This is one favor this poor mom will always regret. After Ethan was feeling better, Auntie quizzed him on his spelling. And when he didn't do well, she proceeded to beat him. And beat him until he was left dead. The father is obviously beyond upset and the mother is catatonic. How could her sister do this? How could anyone do this? Dale could face 25 years in jail if found guilty. I wonder if this knows how to spell life sentence. And now from one crazy woman to a whole other kind of crazy woman. A woman named Sarah has sent $1.4 million to a man she fell in love with online. They've been dating for the last 17 months, but Sarah has never actually seen Chris Olsen in person. That's even his real name. Chris is supposedly a widower and businessman in Milan, Italy. He told Sarah that he's being detained in Africa after being falsely accused of money laundering. She bailed him out of jail and paid all his legal fees and even funded a nanny. Chris has told Sarah that he's tried to leave the country to go see her, but that each time he has been detained. Wow, she really does sound completely gullible, right? How is she even a millionaire? Where did she get all this money? Sarah's 95% that everything Chris has told her is true, it's all legit, and that when he gets home, he's gonna pay her back every penny. Do you think it's safe to say that not only will this woman never see this man, but I doubt she'll be getting back even a dime. Sarah will be appearing on the Dr. Phil show tomorrow, March 3rd, hopefully to finally meet this man face to face. Next up, a man has what may be the world's longest lashes. Imagine getting one of these eyelashes in your eyes. Ouch. But how many girls would kill to have these blinkers? A Ukrainian man grew astonishing long eyelashes after he says he went on a special diet and ate a secret food. And now he's trying to get into the Guinness Book of World Records. 58-year-old Valery Smagley from Ukraine will have his long eyelashes officially measured before finally having them cut. Clearly this man is onto something, but he won't tell what he ate. Women everywhere will want to know his secret. Some girls get eyelash implants to get the same results. Of course he's thinking about marketing his findings, so hopefully soon enough we'll know. If this man applies this to men's hair loss, that's a bingo. Maybe it is something he ate, or maybe it's just Maybelline. And that's what's going on in the world. I'm Sandra Matos. Thanks for watching IO2. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more videos.